so much. Dear colleagues and friends, thank you so much for inviting me to address you at this seminar. And I'm also very happy to be here in St. Petersburg and the Baltic State Technical University again. I would like to use this opportunity to speak about the high Nord policy of the Norwegian government. But let me start by congratulating the organizers of this important event for making it possible for us to meet and discuss governance and cooperation between our countries and regions in the North. The High Nord is the most important foreign policy of the Norwegian government. This has been the situation for more than a decade, also with changing governments. What are the main reasons for this? First of all, Norway is a coastal and maritime nation. Shipping and fishing are essential parts of Norwegian industry and culture. With the increased maritime activities we have seen in the north as a result of increased accessibility, it is natural that the High Nord becomes more globally important. 80% of the Arctic maritime traffic passes through Norwegian waters. Increased fishing, shipping and cruise tourism provide us with many opportunities, but also challenges we need to meet. The Norwegian government is increasing the search and rescue capacity in the region, and we are establishing new oil spill preparedness and response bases. Secondly, the north of Norway is thriving, and the region offers great potential for value creation. There are local variations, but the overall picture is very positive. Over the past 10 years, the negative population trend in North Norway has been reversed, and people are now moving to this part of our country. Almost 10% of the Norwegian population now lives north of the polar circle. The Norwegian government gives priority to knowledge-based business development, innovation and entrepreneurial activity in its High Nord policy. Mapping mineral resources, investing in maritime bioprospecting, and increasing the seafood production are all important activities. Cross-border cooperation is vital for continued sustainable development in the North. Since 1993, the Barents cooperation between the Nordic countries, Russia and the EU has enabled the countries involved to work together in a number of areas. This cooperation ranges from people-to-people projects to joint business development activities. We hope this cooperation can continue as before, even if I have to stress that Norway doesn't accept Russia's violations of international law in Ukraine. As a Norwegian speaking in Russia about High Nord cooperation, I have to mention the Norwegian-Russian cooperation to manage our joint fish stocks in the Barents Sea. Our cooperation in the Barents Sea has been very successful, and the fish stocks are in very good shape. It is important that such cooperation continues, despite overall political changes in our bilateral relations. In the long term, the government will give priority to the following five areas: international cooperation, development of a knowledge-based business sector, knowledge development, infrastructure and emergency preparedness, and environmental protection. Dear friends, the Arctic is a region of peaceful cooperation, stability, respect for international law, and sustainable management of resources. Some people have suggested that current geopolitical tension could spill over and pose a challenge to the peace and stability that characterize the Arctic region. As my colleague Erik Sivertsen underlined in his intervention, it is of the utmost importance to prevent a spill over effect from conflicts in other parts of the world into the Arctic cooperation. We will, however, continue to stress the importance of respecting international law. As neighboring countries in the north, Norway and Russia has been living peacefully side by side for 1,000 years. I will end my presentation by underlining that we want to continue our practical cooperation in the northern regions between Russia and Norway. Especially in times when the cooperation between our national governments is experiencing difficult times. The main goal of the Norwegian government is to keep the Arctic region as an area of peace and cooperation between the Arctic nations to secure a sustainable and prosperous development of the region. Thank you for your attention.